So you have a patient with a phantom limb, the arm has been removed, and you have a phantom, and you watch somebody else being touched, you feel it in your phantom. Now the astonishing thing is, if you have pain in your phantom limb, you squeeze the other person's hand, massage the other person's hand, that relieves the pain in your phantom hand. Almost as though the neuron were obtaining relief from merely watching somebody else being massaged.
I think my favorite thing is the discovery of the mirror neuron system in the brain, the compassion neurons, where they found that compassion is related to the neurotransmitters in the brain, and certain cells, the mirror neurons, are hyperactive in empaths, meaning they're working overtime because empaths feel so much compassion for everybody and everything. And so there are mirror neurons in our brain, wired in our physiology, that help to allow us to feel compassion, as opposed to narcissists, which I also talk about in the Empath Survival Guide, who are empathy, they have empathy deficient disorder, which means their mirror neurons are not operating strongly enough. They're hypoactive, where they don't have the same impulse towards compassion and towards empathy. They just don't feel anything. And therefore, some sociopaths don't have a conscience because they lack this mirror neuron connection, which is so interesting. So how we're wired is kind of God sent, you know, how we're wired neurologically. Now, in the body, if we're wired to feel a lot of compassion through our mirror neuron system, that's a blessing. We just have to learn how to ground ourselves, how to center ourselves, how to use protective visualizations to not take on everything and not become codependent, which is where the other person's life is more important than your own because you're so obsessed with it. You don't want that either. So it's a the empath world, you know, has a lot of predictable challenges in it. And the very common challenges that we all face.
I'd like to talk to you today about the human brain, which is what we do research on at the University of California. Just think about this problem for a second. Here's a lump of flesh, about 3 pounds, which you can hold in the palm of your hand, but it can contemplate the vastness of interstellar space. It can contemplate the meaning of infinity, ask questions about the meaning of its own existence, about the nature of God. And this is truly the most amazing thing in the world. It's the greatest mystery confronting human beings. How does this all come about? Well, the brain, as you know, is made up of neurons. Looking at neurons here, there are 100 billion neurons in the adult human brain, and each neuron makes something like 1,000 to 10,000 contacts with other neurons in the brain. And based on this, people have calculated that the number of permutations and combinations of brain activity exceeds the number of elementary particles in the universe. One recent discovery that has been made by researchers in Italy, in Parma, by Giacomo Rizzolatti and his colleagues, is a group of neurons called mirror neurons, which are in the front of the brain, in the frontal lobes. What Zelati found was a subset of these neurons, maybe about 20% of them, will also fire when I'm looking at somebody else performing the same action. So here's a neuron that fires when I reach and grab something, but it also fires when I watch Joe reaching and grabbing something. And this is truly astonishing because it's as though this neuron is adopting the other person's point of view. It's almost as though it's performing a virtual reality simulation of the other person's action. Now, what is the significance of these mirror neurons? For one thing, they must be involved in things like imitation and emulation, because to imitate a complex act requires my brain to adopt the other person's point of view. So this is important for imitation and emulation. Now, there's another kind of mirror neuron which is involved in something quite different, and that is, there are mirror neurons just as there are mirror neurons for action, there are mirror neurons for touch. In other words, if somebody touches me, my hand, a neuron in the somatosensory cortex, in the sensory region of the brain, fires. But the same neuron, in some cases, will fire when I simply watch another person being touched. So it's empathizing the other person being touched. So most of them will fire when I'm touched in different locations, different neuron for different locations, but a subset of them will fire even when I watch somebody else being touched in the same location. So here again, you have neurons which are involved in empathy. You simply anesthetize my arm. So you put an injection into my arm, anesthetize the brachial plexus, so the arm is numb, there's no sensations coming in. If I now watch you being touched, I literally feel it in my hand. In other words, you've dissolved the barrier between you and other human beings. So I call them Gandhi neurons, or empathy neurons. And this is not in some abstract metaphorical sense. All that's separating you from him, from the other person, is your skin. remove the skin, you experience that person's touch in your mind. You have dissolved the barrier between you and other human beings. And this, of course, is the basis of much of Eastern philosophy, and that is there's no real independent self aloof from other human beings inspecting the world and inspecting other people. You're in fact connected, not just via Facebook and internet. You're actually quite literally connected by your neurons, and there's whole chains of neurons around this room talking to each other, and there is no real distinctiveness of your consciousness from somebody else's consciousness. And this is not mumbo-jumbo philosophy. It emerges from our understanding of basic neuroscience. So here you have my last slide. For the longest time, people have regarded science and humanities as being distinct. C.P. Snow spoke of the two cultures, science on the one hand, humanities on the other, never the twain shall meet. So I'm saying the mirror neuron system lies at the interface, allowing you to think about issues like consciousness, representation of self, what separates you from other human beings, what allows you to empathize with other human beings, and also even things like the emergence of culture and civilization, which is unique to human beings. Thank you.